Let's get back into the context of why this is happening. Now, to a certain extent, it depends on how you decide to understand it, okay? And for some perspective, let's go to the mayor of Atlanta, who in no way wanted to see her city on fire and was very outspoken about it, and also had perspective on why what she doesn't like happening was happening. And it's very important to hear. Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms. Listen to her.
I am a mother. I am a mother to four black children in America, one of whom is 18 years old. And when I saw the murder of George Floyd, I hurt like a mother would hurt. And on yesterday, when I heard there were rumors about violent protests in Atlanta, I did what a mother would do. I called my son and I said, "Where are you?" I said, "I cannot protect you, and black boys shouldn't be out today. So you're not going to out-concern me and out-care about where we are in America. I wear this each and every day, and I pray over my children each and every day. So what I see happening on the streets of Atlanta is not Atlanta. This is not a protest. This is not in the spirit of Martin Luther King Jr. This is chaos. A protest has purpose. When Dr. King was assassinated, we didn't do this to our city. So if you love this city that has had a legacy of black mayors and black police chiefs and people who care about this city, where more than 50% of the business owners in Metro Atlanta are minority business owners. If you care about this city, then go home and pray that somebody like Reverend Beasley will come and talk to you and give you some instructions on what a protest should look like and how you effectuate change in America. This police chief made a video on yesterday, pull it up on YouTube, where she said she was appalled to watch the murder of George Floyd. This woman did that. You're not honoring the legacy of Martin Luther King Jr. and the civil rights movement. You're not protesting anything, running out with brown liquor in your hands, breaking windows in this city. T.I. and Killer Mike own half the West Side. So when you burn down this city, you're burning down our community. If you want change in America, go and register to vote. Show up at the polls on June 9th. Do it in November. That is the change we need in this country. You are disgracing our city. You are disgracing the life of George Floyd and every other person who has been killed in this country. We are better than this. We're better than this as a city. We are better than this as a country. Go home. Go home. In the same way I couldn't protect my son on yesterday, I cannot protect you out in those streets. You're throwing knives at our police officers. You are burning cars. You have defaced the CNN building. Ted Turner started CNN in Atlanta 40 years ago because he believed in who we are as a city. There was a black reporter who was arrested on camera this morning who works for CNN. They are telling our stories, and you are disgracing their building. This is not the legacy of civil rights in America. This is chaos, and we're buying into it. This won't change anything. We're no longer talking about the murder of an innocent man. We're talking about how you're burning police cars on the streets of Atlanta, Georgia. Go home.
Now, that is not just incredibly powerful and poignant, but it is also perspective from an African-American mother and leader. How are those words received? Well, one answer is on the streets before you right now. Not fair to judge the mayor's echo by Los Angeles, but her own city was on fire tonight again after she said that. Van Jones, I know that some of that I've heard you say before, and some of it I am not hearing you say right now. When she's saying go home, you are disgracing the legacy, you are distracting the narrative, you are resembling what you say you oppose. This is wrong how you're doing this. Your take.
Well, listen, I mean, that was leadership. And it was leadership that resonated because it was tied to something more than just calling you a thug. See, when you call people out, you lose your audience. She was calling them up. You could feel the love underneath the anger. You could feel the love underneath the rage. She was saying, you are better than this. And you are part of something bigger than this. And you need to go home because you're out here destroying your own legacy. That's different than saying you're a bunch of thugs and putting people down, expecting them to rise. And so there's a quality of leadership that she represents that is sorely missing, unfortunately, throughout the country. And I'm not surprised that people didn't heed her word, but that's the model. What I will say is this: hurt people holler. Hurt people holler. And one of the things that we're dealing with right now is it's hard to speak up when you see injustice, when things are going wrong, when a department first starts to go sour, when you start seeing things that don't make sense. But if you speak up and you're not heard, then you might shout. If you shout and then you're still not heard, then you might scream. If you scream and you're still not heard, then you might throw something. Look at your own children and how they act. When there's something desperately wrong and no one will listen, people go to more and more extreme forms of expression and then of action. Not to justify it, but that's there. So if you are concerned about lawlessness, and by the way, I'm raising two black boys in Los Angeles. I'm not a part of any pro-riot lobby or any pro-crime lobby. I want peaceful streets. But I know that if I want to end lawlessness in LA, I've got to make sure there is not lawlessness in the police precincts in LA. And that is the challenge that we have here. Let's hold young people to high standards and not relax and not relent. And let's hold grown folk to higher standards. The problem I have with a lot of critics of what they're seeing is that they are very, very quick to raise the standards on young, desperate people, some of whom are just out there acting a fool and are knuckleheads. Some are out there for a good purpose. There's a mix. But they're quick to raise the standard for them, but lower the standard for law enforcement. And that's how you get anarchy. That is a perfect formula for anarchy. If you don't want anarchy, insist on law and order in the ranks of our police. Make sure our police are obeying the law. When did you become a radical to say that the police should obey the law? And so this is a delicate thing, but I applaud that mayor, I call her Keisha, because I know her very, very well, but I applaud the mayor. She is calling people up to a higher standard and not just calling people out for their mistakes and misdeeds.